most important monuments in the nation, the War Memorial. There is a buzz in the air in the sold-out arena here in Indianapolis, Indiana. Kevin Harlan here with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. Game 5, currently the series at 3-1, so a spot in the finals can be had tonight. Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the Eastern Conference Finals action here on 2K Sports. And now we take a brief check at the matchups. Our starting five for both teams. Someone will be keeping an eye on, of course, LeBron James.
Well, it's an almost impossible task guarding him. He's so strong and quick. LeBron is like a locomotive bearing down. You see why teams have to give hard fouls to stop him, because a little bit of contact just is not going to be enough to stop him.
Hey, Steve, a lot of contact isn't enough to stop the freight train LeBron James. I mean, he draws so much attention defensively, but what makes him special is how he can punish a defense for overcommitting, because I think his greatest attribute, amongst all of his great attributes, is his passing ability.
Look at Indiana, right now trailing 3-1. It's a must-win as they look to stretch their way back into the series.
And Kevin, it's make-or-break time for them now. They've got to win these next 3 in a row. But they do have 2 of them at home, so it's not out of the question.
Not by any means, Steve. I mean, I know they feel like they're still in this, and they are. If they can not only win this game, but win it big, that might swing a lot of the momentum back their way, and game 6 would become very interesting at that point.
And that one's good.
Right there, we saw Bosch opened up space for the shooter. Well done.
Heat on D. They are really pleased with the victory on Monday.
Well, they benefited from some very loose play from their opponents that night, Clark.
Yeah, you're exactly right. I mean, there were a lot of turnovers in that game. Some were caused by their good defensive play, but some were just careless.
Here's LeBron. Roy Hibbert picking up.
Oh my goodness.
What a huge play.
Putting on a show for these people.
I cannot believe he pulled that one out in the course of an actual game. Are you kidding me?
Shooting their first free throw of the contest. Free throw good, LeBron. We're about 1 minute into the first. And here are the Pacers now. Hill with it. Now guarded by Mario Chalmers. Here's Hibbert. The shot's good on the assist by West. James with it. First quarter of play with about 1.5 minutes gone. He kicks it to Bosch. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Bosch has got his first 2 points of the night.
He's got so much junk in his trunk, he'll find a way to hurt you.
Hill against Chalmers. Feeds it to West. Again, Indiana.
4 makes on 4 tries. Everything's falling early. 100%. Can't do better than that.
George against LeBron. Bosch heads the pick for James. Huffs off the pick and hammers it home. Guys back and forth this first half.
Well, 5 lead changes early on, guys, as we grapple back and forth.
Yeah, this could be a back and forth game all the way, guys, the way it's being played. This is fun to watch.
Now, here is Hill. And Shingadia gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. And stolen by LeBron.
He was on that pass in a flash. Read it, reacted, and then picked it off.
He feeds it to Battier. Battier right side. Can't cash in from close range.
I like the work there. Contesting that shot that looked like it was going to be easy, but they forced the miss.
You know what? He got it in close, but couldn't finish in traffic. You know, that's a case there, Kevin, of him making a pass to a spot, and then he let his teammate run right into it. Well executed.
There's Chalmers after David West's bucket. Wade dishes to Bosch.
Trying for it.
Out of bounds. Indiana takes possession. Here are the NBA's top scorers during this postseason, as shown on the 2K leaderboard. LeBron James second.
Well, he's almost unstoppable. He's got so many different ways he can hurt you and put the ball in the basket. And it seems as though he raises his level during the postseason.
Hill against Chalmers. Hill kicks it to West. Now, here's Stevenson. He's guarded closely. Lock at six. The kick out to Hill. Floats one up, and it's blocked by Bosch. On the wing, James. Back to Wade. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron. Wade's got his second basket.
Well, the number one priority for a defense when you face this guy is to keep him getting anywhere from the basket because he's just so strong as a finisher.
And what amazing skills he has as a distributor, too, Steve. He doesn't just pass the ball effectively. He does it in spectacular fashion, too.
And so he draws the foul on the shot and a trip to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, he got whacked. Shouldn't be much debate on that one.
Yeah, that was as straightforward as it gets, guys.
The Pacers shooting their first free throws of the game. First one falls for him, and the Heat with some changes. Anderson, he's checked in for Bosch. Lewis comes in for Shane Battier, and it's James Jones in for James. Second free throw, no good.
Miss at the line. Might stick in his craw for a while. Always hurts to miss a chance to take the lead.
Jones, no luck. For Indiana, they've gotten only one of their first six shots to fall today. Hudson with it. Rashard Lewis covering. Watson, the pass to George. Scola, dishes to Watson. Here's Hibbert, the turnaround jumper. Hibbert's got his third basket of the night right there. Here's Cole. We've got 1:28 left to play in the first quarter. This is it to Lewis. For three, and that one's good. It has been nip and tuck through the first half.
No kidding. I mean, neither team has been able to hold the lead for any length of time, guys.
Steve, so close.
Wow, such a seesaw affair back and forth. I mean, this has been an unbelievable game to watch.
And George kicks to Hibbert. Shoots from the block. The rebound by Anderson. For Miami, they've gone 6 of 8 in the game so far. A very solid start for them. Cole, the pass to Anderson. Dishes to Jones. Hibbert against Anderson. Soft touch on the glass. Anderson's got his first 2 points of the night.
If you battle for the offensive rebound and come up with it, you're guaranteed a high quality shot on a follow just like he got there.
George dishes to Scola. Indiana moving it around. A 15 footer. That is good. Turner's got his first basket. We've got 28 seconds left in the first. And Cole kicks to Jones. And Scola with the block. Now, here is George. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Here is Watson. Pass to Scola. He got it up. That misses. Would have counted had it gone in. A nice first quarter of play. We've seen plenty of offense so far. Heat lead by one. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break.
Game 5 of the Western Conference Finals. Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder go on the road to do battle with the San Antonio Spurs. It's the NBA Thursday.
Welcome welcome back to our coverage of the NBA Eastern Conference Final as we get things started once again. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Heat.
Well, I like the fact they've already been getting a lot of high-quality shots in the paint.
And the other thing we're seeing is great ball movement. We're seeing a lot of good offensive execution, ball movement, player movement, setting up assists.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. On the court for Indiana, at the one and two, George Hill and Lance Stephenson. Scola out there with Mahimi. And it's Turner in at the three spot. They get it back. Mahimi, and he uses the glass on the layup. Mahimi's got the first points up on the board here in the second quarter for the Pacers. James against Scola. James, the pass to Cole. Plays it up and banks it in. And the Heat lead by one.
Wow, this has been a thriller. I mean, the way these teams are battling, just going back and forth.
Would you like to bet that this game may end on a buzzer beater? How much would you bet?
Now, here is Hill. Here's Scola. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. And the Heat with some changes. Adier comes in for Ray Allen. And it's Chalmers in for Cole. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Pacers.
You know what, guys? It looks to me like they're really in sync here, all on the same page. They've already got a bunch of assists.
And I like the physical play we're seeing, too, because this is a club that's really pounding the paint area and scoring inside. Pretty bad defense, letting the offense get right to the rim, but smart play to foul once he was there.
But you know what's going to happen, and they sent a message right there. It's nothing easy inside.
Miami shooting their second and third free throws tonight. First free throw is good. West is checked in for Indiana. On that one, so he goes one for two at the line. The Pacers have gone 2 of 4 shooting the ball here in the second. Hill dishes to West. Kicks it to Mahimi. Outside Turner. And a missed layup.
Some rugged defense there against one of the stronger finishers in the game.
Bosch is screen on West, and there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Well, good idea setting that screen, but the execution wasn't there.
No, it sure wasn't. I mean, you want it to be hard, but it also has to be legal.
And for the Pacers, they're shooting around 60% on the night. Amazing work offensively so far. Here's Hill. Rebounded by Battier.
Boy, I tell you what, guys, he's an extremely strong finisher. I'm surprised he wasn't able to power that through the defense.
Here's Wade. Nice defense from Turner. Stephenson with it. And Bosch picks him up defensively. The kick out to Hill. Now, here's Stephenson. Defended by Chalmers. Now Stephenson. The shot no good. Some solid defense from Battier. And here is Chalmers. He dishes it to LeBron. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Tell you what, LeBron can absolutely soar in for the finish. I remember last year the alley-oop in the conference finals against Indiana just almost put his head on the rim.
Air Freight is a nickname we could dub LeBron James. I mean, he's an unstoppable force and an immovable object. Defensively, the strength, length, mobility. He can wall you up and lock you down and put you away.
The Free throw drops for James. Chris Anderson has checked in for Chris Bosh. And both free throws, good for James.
Another trip to the stripe for him, and I tell you what, a little bit of a different feel here in the second quarter. A little more banging going on.
This team is never afraid to get physical. I think they enjoy this style of play.
Mahimi's shot is good. Mahimi's got it all tied up now for the Pacers.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, Clark, just piling up points in the paint.
Now, here is Battier. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Stevenson kicks to Turner. And there's the pass to Hill. Back to Turner. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. Hill's got his fourth assist in this one.
Well, we've seen that more than a few times. An easy bucket in the lane.
Yeah, the interior defense simply has been lifeless.
Anderson, great pass to set up the lay-in.
Good look. He'll make that one most of the time.
And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. So the Pacers call timeout, their first of the game. A look at the 2K leaderboard with the list of the best shooters during the postseason. Fourth, LeBron James.
Well, you always want to shoot a high percentage, and that goes back to the kind of shots you get. But there's no better time than the postseason to knock down most of the shots that you take.
And the Heat making a change here. Now, here's Stevenson, guarded closer. George passes to West, and he gets it to go. West has got the lead up to two now for Indiana.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Boy, the ball movement's been fantastic here in the last few possessions.
Now, here's Wade. He's covered by Watson. Lewis dishes to Anderson. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in. Anderson's got six.
Give an assist there, not for the pass, but for the solid screen set on the inside that freed him up and made the layup possible.
Watson's shot is good.
Three consecutive baskets have come right at the rim. The defense had better start buckling down and tightening up.
Yeah, they're getting exposed right now.
Now, here's Chalmers. Shot's good. He has five.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
There's 1:17 left here in the second. Here is Watson, defended by Chalmers, stolen by Anderson. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Here's Jones. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. And the Heat lead by two. Pacers have gone 6 of 11 from the floor. Over 50% shooting here in the second quarter. Stolen by Anderson. And here's the fast break. Chalmers leading the way. And it's sent back by George. And he gets the bucket. There's 45 seconds left in the first half.
I'd like to see them go 2-for-1 here.
I would, too. They need to make this a quick possession and a fruitful one, too.
Stolen by Anderson. Here's Jones. And the shot is good. And now a 6-point Heat lead.
Even with the D lurking, he made it look easy with the soft finger roll.
The dish now to Hibbert. To end the run. And off the front iron. And in it goes. Hibbert's got 9. We've got 22 seconds left in the second quarter. Now, here's Chalmers. He's covered by Watson. And Chalmers kicks to Anderson. And stolen by Watson. Good. And now just a 2-point Miami lead.
Great D.
Picked it off and took it all the way for the solo finish.
A drive by Wade, and no good trying to get that one. And a tight game here as we end the first half. Heat out front. They lead by two. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Dwayne, give us your perspective on that first half.
I like the way we started the game. You know, sometimes on the road we start off slow, so I thought we got to the fight early. And it's our two good teams, so, you know, it's the way it should be.
Dwayne, thank you. Always fun to watch. Guys, over to you.
Thanks, Doris. And, folks, the halftime show is coming up next. And then it's on to the third quarter. We'll step aside right now.
Now, presented by Sprint.
Hello out there and welcome to the Halftime Report as the conference finals continue on 2K Sports. The Heat in a tight one against the Indiana Pacers. They want to keep the momentum going. One more win and this series is put away. The first half, a productive one for LeBron. He's got 7 points and also has contributed with his passing, making some assists. But the Pacers getting after it as well. Just a special performance for them offensively. They simply can't be denied. Roy Hibbert playing well in the first half. They also like what they've seen out of David West, too. That's all we've got here. Now, back to Kevin, Steve, Clark, and Doris for the second half.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And we're back here at Game 5 with more action about to get underway.
Good game for Hibbert. He has 9 points and also a block shot.
The Heat with the lead. Here's who Eric Spoelstra is starting the second half. Chalmers and D. Wade are the guards. Chris Bosh is out there with Shane Battier, and it's LeBron in the three slot.
Can't let him that close to the basket. It's almost a guaranteed finish when he gets into the paint.
And Indiana shooting has been just fantastic, around 65% tonight, getting exactly what they want when they want it. Hill kicks to Stevenson. Good.
Some big points there. I mean, they got him on a nice play to get the ball right to the bucket.
That's what they're looking for down the stretch, Clark. More of the same. Get it inside.
Now here's Jenkins. He's got 7. To the middle. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot 2. The Heat shooting their 6th and 7th free throw attempts tonight. That one falls for Wade. And Wade drops them both. And a minute played as the second half gets going. Hill against Chalmers. Hill passes to Hibbert. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. He shot 2 free throws in the game, made 1 and missed 1.
2 shots.
Free throw, good, Hibbert. That one misses. Miami leading by 3. Here's Chalmers, and he gets it to go.
Now, when he gets an opening like that, he'll definitely take it.
Pacers shooting wonderfully up to this point, 67%. Now, here's Stevenson. Defense right on him. James dishes to Chalmers. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. Now it's a 7-point Heat lead.
They've been good on all three of their shots since coming out of the locker room at the break.
Chalmers against Hill. The feed to Stevenson. They get it again. West. And that's good. A nice job on the glass as they pick up two on the second effort.
Well, where was the box out? Too easy on that second chance opportunity.
Yeah, no box out is what happened there. Those kind of mistakes on the glass will kill a team.
Now here's LeBron. Battier with him. Picked up by Hibbert. And good on the basket. Book it. Bosch has got the lead up to seven now for Miami.
Well, it's been a great start for this offense here in the second half. 4 for 4.
Timeout called the Pacers.
And I think he believes that if he takes some time here to kind of talk things over, it'll be well served for this club.
And, you know, maybe this gives him an opportunity to toy around with some of their game plan while he has their attention during this break in the action.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Well, guys, I was able to listen in on what Eric Spoelstra was going over with his team in that last huddle. He wants his players to step up the pace. He told them they should be looking to get out and run every chance they get. He also told them their offense needs to center around the pick and roll. That's a play he feels they can use to really exploit the weaknesses in this defense. Those could prove to be crucial changes to their strategy with this game getting ready to enter the stretch drive, Kevin.
Thanks again, Doris. The Pacers making a change here. Turner's checked in.
Evan Turner.
Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Pass to Hill. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And it's Turner off the drive. The baseline jumper goes down. Turner's got his third basket of the night.
He shouldn't be afraid to take that shot more often. He's solid for me.
LeBron against George. And the shot is good. 9 points for LeBron.
Well, I tell you what, I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders. They're not getting the job done.
Yeah, that's 10 of the last 12 points they've allowed on good looks right at the rim.
Now here's Scola. And here we go with Allen running it up the court. James left side. He kicks it to Cole. Battier against Scola. Cole the pass to LeBron. And he gets it to go. And now a 9-point Heat lead.
Well, he's clearly feeling it, Clark, coming off that fantastic game last time out.
Outside Hill. Feeds it to Scola. The kick out to Hill. Shoots. And he overshot that one, missing.
You know, not really a significant margin in terms of them rebounding, but enough to get the job done.
Yeah, I mean, it's helping them get the lead. And if they can continue to rebound like this, I think they're going to be in pretty good shape.
For Indiana, they've gone 3 of 7 on field goal attempts here in the second half. Scola with it. Picked up by Battier. And Turner kicks to George. Passes it to Hill. Back to Turner. Shot from 16. Here's Scola. And he uses the glass on the layup. Scola's got his second bucket of the night.
Very high quality shot. Can't get enough of those.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game. Chris Anderson has checked in for Miami. Heat leading by 9. Cole dishes to Allen. Over to the left wing. Here Here's Cole. He's covered by Watson. Great defense that time from Watson. For Indiana, they've gone 4 of 9 from the floor so far in the third. He feeds it to Mahimi. Dishes it to Turner. Pass to Scola. Tries to save it. Out of bounds. Miami takes possession. Miami with the ball. Here's Cole. Lewis outside. Kicks it to Anderson. Back to Lewis. Good ball movement here by the Heat. And Anderson slams it in.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Well, they already had him staggered, and now all of a sudden they're throwing some haymakers.
Now here's Scola. And that's out of bounds. Indiana will retain possession. West is checked in for Luis Scola. Here is Watson, covered by Cole. Yep, it goes in, and the Miami lead is cut down now to just 9 in the bucket from David West.
Another good offensive possession for him. He's trying to shoulder the load here for his team.
Here's Cole. And that one's good. Cole's got the lead up to 11 now for Miami. 9 seconds left to play in the third. Watson with it, and it's blocked by Cole. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Heat lead by 11. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the fourth quarter gets underway. We end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit. Will make it tough to come back. In a moment now to check out our State Farm assist of the game, and what a pass it was by a talented point guard.
Now, this is what he does. This is the kind of plays he's known for, Kevin.
Pacers trail by 11. Paul George is the 3 with David West at the 4. And Stevenson is out there with Watson. And it's Hibbert in at the pivot spot manning the middle. That's the Pacers 5. And that one's good.
Well, something special about him, guys, is just how good he is at winning the so-called second shot game, going hard to the offensive left, salvaging points with his putback.
And something else you can't forget about is his shot blocking, Steve. I mean, he's an attempt.
Oh! Ridiculous.
It down that time.
Punches it down with pop.
Rubs it in. It looks like a little deeper with the hanging finish.
Well, they're not backing off at all, are they?
And the replay, of course, presented by Kia. What a play. Here's Watson, and it's blocked by Bosch. Out of bounds, Indiana takes possession.
Well, just a brain cramp, guys. I mean, that should have been the simplest of exchanges.
And Miami making a change here. Battier's checked in. For Indiana, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Now, here's Stevenson. Wade is covering. So the whistle blows on the shot, and 2 free throws for the contact right there.
What a tremendous game for West. 10 points, and he was able to come up with 1 steal, too.
Yeah, he's defending very well, Clark. He's disrupting the offense. He's playing the passing lanes, trying to put as much pressure on as possible.
And he knocks down the first one. Mm-hmm. And both free throws good for West. Fourth quarter of basketball. We're about a minute into it. LeBron kicks to Wade. Dwayne Wade on the wing. Wade left side. Here's Battier. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. Wade's got three assists now in this one. Pacers trail by 12. And the Pacers call time here.
Well, they're getting way too many easy shots in the paint. So this timeout is specifically for that reason. You got to tighten up the defense and start to make it harder for that offensive team.
I know it's easier said than done, but right now it just doesn't seem like the necessary effort is there.
And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Frank Vogel addressing his team. He let his players know that they've got to do a better job on defense. He said, they're scoring any way they want. We've got to show some pride here. Let's make a stand defensively, get us stops, and get on a run of our own. Do they have it in them, Kevin?
Thanks a lot, Doris. And he gets the bucket.
Boy, the deeper we get into this game, the more offense we're seeing.
And that goes for both teams, Steve. Everybody firing on all cylinders right now.
Now here's James. He dishes it to Buck. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Yeah, he got whacked. Shouldn't be much debate on that one.
Yeah, that was as straightforward as it gets, guys.
In a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Heat.
Well, they're getting into the paint with their penetration, and it's really been key for this club.
You know, they're taking care of business in the paint, too. Those are valuable points they've been getting down low.
First one falls for him. George Hill's checked in for Indiana. And so Bosch nails both of them.
They got to keep fighting their way to the line, guys. This half, it's been nothing but success for them there.
And their confidence has to just continue to go up the longer their perfection continues.
Hill kicks to Hibbert. And he converts the layup.
Tell you what, he's enjoyed a very good day shooting the ball so far. He can bring them right back into this.
LeBron passes to Wade. LeBron against George. LeBron kicks to Bosh. The pass to Batty. Six on the shot clock. And Wade slams it in.
But it's been so sound offensively in the second half. I love the way they're playing.
Yeah, there's really no comparison in the shooting percentages between the teams since the break.
The Pacers really have to improve their approach against Wade.
12 points, and he hasn't forgotten to get his teammates involved either.
Well, that's important, Clark. I mean, he's conscious of the fact that moving the ball around gets the defense to move. It forces them to work, and it creates a better offensive flow for his own team.
Hill dishes to Stevenson. Here's West. No luck. And Miami the other way now. Now Chalmers inside to Bosch. That's good, and so Chalmers with the assist. Chalmers has got his third assist on the night.
That's pretty much been the norm for them, getting their points off assist and great ball movement.
Nice rhythm and flow for this team. Tremendous communication and alertness.
He's looking for LeBron and finds him. That's good.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today, ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass?
Well, if you just looked at assist as the measuring stick, they've been by far the better team.
West passes to George. Hill against Chalmers. Hill kicks it to West. Outside West. Falls back and drains the fadeaway jumper.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it didn't work. Not if it results in that shot.
Now a timeout called by Miami.
Well, he wants to get everybody on the same wavelength, that's for sure. He may change up some things here as well.
Looks to me like he saw something that wasn't on the plan and picked now as the time to address it. I don't have a problem with that.
And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Kevin, I was able to hear the advice Frank Vogel gave to his team during that last break. He said their offense has been a little too sluggish for his liking, saying, quote, take what the defense gives you. Don't hesitate to let those shots fly. The second thing he mentioned was that they need to play a chaotic brand of defense, not the careful kind. He said, quote, go ahead and take some risks out there. With the minutes ticking down and the deficit still a big one, those adjustments have to be a chance worth taking, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris. Pacers trail by 17. Outside Hill. Beyond the arc. And the shot is good.
You know, defensively, you cannot forget about him. They gave him a wide open look there.
He'd have gotten absolutely red hot shooting the ball here in the fourth. A perfect 6-for-6. It's stolen by Hill. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
Oh, the kind of moments you love to see. Excellent defense. Leading to a dunk at the other end.
Clark, you got to marvel at the transition game when they've got it clicking. It's really explosive.
High octane for sure.
Oof. Yeah, turning defensive pressure into offensive opportunities. That's what it's all about.
1:35 left in the game. And out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession. Indiana, they're working against the clock right now. The dish to George. The three. Good. The assist goes to Hill. Hill's got 5 assists tonight.
They're looking significantly better now. Still a long way to go to get all the way back into this.
Well, at least the effort's there now. It had been sorely lacking early.
And what's your take, guys, on the hustle sticks for the Pacers?
Their high-energy defensive effort has paid off for them, guys, with more than a few steals over the course of the ballgame.
And the other thing they're doing, Clark, is scoring a lot of points off turnovers, forcing mistakes, and cashing in.
Wash inside. He's against Hibbert. Shot clock at 5. The drive by James. No good again that time. Indiana's gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. A jump hook, and there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. That's on LeBron James. Well, he holds the reins to this team, and we're seeing some examples of that, Steve, right now.
Yeah, they look cohesive. And, you know, anytime he takes control, you can just feel this group come together.
Yeah, it's priceless when you have a guy who sets the example he does and then backs it up with timely communication as well as consistent performance.
First free throw is good, and that turns the lead to 6. And George drops them both.
Those were critical foul shots because we're at the point now where they can't be missing any of those.
Now here's Wade. D right on him. There's the feed to James. On the wing, Battier. Heat moving the ball around. It's stolen by Hill.
And they've got to score quickly.
Yeah, no time to waste at all.
Pass to Stevenson. Leaps for it, and so it looks like the Pacers will retain possession here. Timeout called. The Pacers, they're down by 5. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And he gets it to go.
That's
that's how you get the crowd on its feet.
Huge bucket.
They've been waiting for that one, guys.
For Miami, they've gone 6 of 8 from the field in the fourth so far. It's been a great start to this final quarter for them.
Well, you do what you have to do to extend this game and try to get the ball back.
In this situation, clock management crucial.
We've got 22 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one, and now they decide to foul intentionally. Point cushion. And the second free throw, no good. A tough break there. Timeout called the Pacers. They're losing by 4. 20 seconds left to play here on the fourth. Here's Indiana. They're on a 16-3 run right now. And George, here we go. Here's West. Some solid defense from Battier.
An excellent interior defense there. Good rotations.
No doubt about it, Steve. He's a real presence inside. Takes up a lot of space.
Shane Bati. Two shots.
It's the first one, and that puts them up by 5. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a 6-point ball game.
And that's exactly how you close a game out. Those free throws will bury them for sure.
Three from Stevenson. Excellent D from Wade. And so the Miami Heat have won the series.
And you can see the elation on their faces. I mean, not just happiness, but pure excitement and joy to be headed to the NBA Finals.
A tremendous opportunity now, just 4 wins away from a championship.
And then guys, tonight, time to celebrate, enjoy the win, and then tomorrow it's back to the practice court, into the film room, and time to prepare for what's ahead. But what a moment tonight, and a great time for this franchise.
And they'll represent the East in a final series that's mere days away. And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, and the whole crew from 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long, and thanks for watching the NBA Eastern Conference Finals. Now let's take a look at the Jordan Player of the Game.